Students, we are learning branch accounts. In branch account, we are learning stock and debtor system. Here, there are two situations. The first situation, the head office sends goods to its branch at cost price. We are going to solve the first problem. Look at the board. Sum number one, stock and debtor system. Head office sends goods to its branch at cost price. The Calcutta Commercial Company invoiced goods to its Chennai branch at cost. The head office paid all expenses except petty expenses paid by the branch. So all expenses paid by the head office, but petty expenses paid by the branch. From the following, prepare branch expenses account, branch debtor account, branch stock account, and the branch profit and loss account, and information relating to the problem. Opening stock, opening debtor, opening petty cash, goods sent to branch, goods returned to head office, cash sales, advertisement, cash received from debtor, closing debtor, allowance to customer, discount allowed, bad debts, goods returned by customers, salary and wages, rent and rates, closing debtor, closing petty cash, and credit sales are given. Now, first I am going to prepare petty expenses. Here, I said earlier, the expenses are two type. One is cash expenses, another one is non-cash expenses. Cash expenses, what we have to do in branch expenses, debit side, we'll write to bank. Yes. First, I am going to prepare branch expenses account. I'm going to take the cash expenses. Yes, here where we are, we have to take the cash expenses. Advertisement is a cash expenses. Salary, wages, and rent and rates. These three are considered to be cash expenses. Branch expenses debit side, we should write to bank. Advertisement, 2,400. Salary and wages, 18,600. Then rent and rates 3,600. So total cash expenses paid by the head office 24,600. Then expenses and losses related to debtor, such as bad debts, discount allowed, allowance, that we should record in the debit side as branch debtor. For that, what we will take, allowance to customer, discount allowed, bad debts. We'll add this allowance 600, discount allowed 4,200, bad debts 1,800. So the total expenses and losses incurred in relation to the debtor 6,600. Then petty expenses paid by the branch. Its value not given, but we can consider how we can take opening petty cash 600. Closing petty cash 300. So the difference between opening petty cash and closing petty cash, we should consider that one as petty expenses. Its value rupees 300. So the entire branch expenses should be transferred to the branch profit and loss account. We'll add this 24,600 plus 6,600 plus 300. So total value 31,500. It should be transferred to branch profit and loss account. In branch profit and loss account, it should be debited as branch expenses. Its value 31,500. We completed branch expenses account. Then we have to prepare debtor account. For that, we'll take information relating to the debtor. Okay. First, we'll take opening debtor. Opening debtor recorded in the debit side of debtor account as to balance BD. Opening debtor value 37,800. Then opening debtor petty cash return to head office, cash sales, advertisement, cash received from debtor. This we'll write in the credit side as buy cash. Cash received from debtor 85,500. Then closing stock, the allowance bad debts and discount allowed, how we should write in branch debtor account credit side, we should write as branch expenses. Here we debited, no, that should be credited here as branch expenses. Value 6,600. Then goods returned by the customer. It is called sales return. It should be recorded in the credit side of branch debtor account as buy branch stock account. value 1500. Salary, wages, rent, rates, closing debtor. Closing debtor credited by balance CD. The closing debtor 29,400. Then petty cash not required, credit sale we need. In branch debtor account debit side, we should write as branch stock account. This is credit sales. This is credit sales. Value 85,200. Year opening debtor, credit sale, cash received from debtor, closing debtor. So all four important informations are given, definitely the branch debtor account will agree. 37,800 plus 85,200. So debit side total 1,23,000, credit side total 85,500 plus 6,600 plus 1,500 plus 29,400. Definitely it should agree, because all information related to branch debtor are given. Then we have to prepare branch stock account. Here we have to take information relating to the stock. Yes, we will take stock items. Yes, first we will take opening stock. It will be recorded in the debit side as to balance BD. Opening stock 21,000. Debtor will not come, petty cash will not come, goods sent to branch. It will be debited in the branch stock account as goods sent to branch. Value 78,000. Then goods returned to the head office, it will be credited as goods sent to branch. Value 3000. Then cash sales, it should be credited as by cash. Value 52,500. Advertisement will not come, cash will not come, closing stock, it will be credited in the branch stock account. Already we learned the format of these ledger accounts. 19,500. Allowance will not come, discount allowed will not come, bad debts will not come, goods returned by customer, it will be debited in the branch stock account as branch debtor account. Value 1500. Then salary, wages will not come, rent and rates will not come, closing debtor will not come, closing petty cash will not come, credit sale will come. It will be credited to the branch stock account as by branch debtor. Branch debtor account, its value 85,200. Here head office sends goods to branch at cost price. Definitely branch stock account credit side total heavier than the debit side total. 52,500 plus 3000 plus 85,200 plus 19,500. The total of credit side 160,200 minus 21,000 minus 78,000 minus 1500. So the balancing figure 59,700, that we will consider as surplus of stock. Surplus of stock we should transfer it to branch profit and loss account. Balancing figure. So the branch stock account balance recorded in the debit side, that we will consider surplus of stock, we should record as branch profit and loss account. In branch profit and loss account, it will be credited as by branch stock account. Branch stock account, its value 59,700. Then students will balance this. So credit side total 59,700 minus 31,500. So our profit is 28,200. This we should transfer it to general profit and loss account. This we consider as profit of the branch. Students, we completed first problem in relation to the stock and debtor system. In next class, we'll solve different problem. Till then, bye and thank you.